The pathways to impact statement is to do with impact for who will benefit, how they will benefit, and what you will do. So think of this as two steps for knowledge translation or mobilization. The first step is just awareness or engagement, which is one way. You just transfer, disseminate your knowledge. The second step is helping people decide, make decisions. So this is knowledge uptake, adoption, and implementation. So again, use smarter objectives, give specific target groups. I've given you some ideas here of who you could target, the type of event you will be holding, and then how you will evaluate your knowledge exchange activity. So this will look like something like this for 2 pages. Elaborate that last paragraph of the project objectives, which was about outcomes and impact. So give a summary of what you will achieve, then nominate who your audiences will be, and then how they will benefit beyond academia, for example, economic, public health, environment, and then what you will do as itemized activities and interventions. So will it be telephone interviews? Will it be a questionnaire? Will it be chatting to some stakeholders? And will it be forming guidelines at the end that practitioners can use? Then it's a good idea to do an abstract last, because this will summarize bits from the project objectives and the project statement. Define your problem at the beginning and explain why it's important and what the specific problem is. Then pose your question or hypothesis and approach. Then go down the hierarchy from goal to aim to objectives and strategy. And then promote your team to say why they are suitable and why they have the expertise. But you can put this earlier on if your study is a continuation project, because your work will be defined earlier on in the abstract. And then at the end, you have to predict your outcomes, make sure that you say you will answer the question or give a solution to the problem, and your work will be useful for the field and world. Messaging is important. When you give the general status or talk about other people's work, actually frame it so that the positive, the good news comes before the bad news. So although something negative, although something positive, then end with the negative. That's going to be your problem. Then when you talk about your work or what your proposed project is, it's best to start with the negative, with the bad news, and end with the positive. So although negative point, then end with positive point, because that's what you will be promising to do in your study. Don't just say knowledge is lacking, so knowledge gap is not enough. You have to explain the importance and go through step by step to lead the funder to believe why your work is important. And don't just say you'll describe the effect of X on Y, because if your study design was a randomized controlled trial and you use wording such as describe, then you've turned your project into a descriptive study and observational.